Up until this point, we've simply been checking if the error coming back is nil, but we can actually do more informative, robust checks to handle errors we may not have considered and to give ourselves better debug info. Let's start by looking at this function here at the top. This function, displayError, we've created to print out the errors that we find and to re-enable the UI. So this looks like something we can use in all of our other error checks. Awesome. Now let's go back to the first error we check. It's this, the error value that gets returned from our network request. Previously, we were checking if this value equals nil by using an if statement. We're now going to use a guard statement to make this check, and we'll do this as well with the other checks we're making, in addition to some new errors we're checking for. We'll explain guard statements a little bit, but if you're completely unfamiliar with them, you should definitely check out the guard statement Swift syntax lesson. To explain guard statements, let's look at what we're doing with this data that gets returned. If you recall from before, we were using optional binding, that's the if-let syntax, to get our data out of optional form and make sure it exists. We're actually still checking that, but in a slightly different way. By using the guard statement, we're actually now only checking if the data doesn't exist, and using our displayError function to display an error if that's the case. If the data does exist, we get to move on and data is no longer in optional form. This is nice because it's quick and it allows us to avoid those large nested if statements. You can see that down here we've made the same small adjustment for photos, dictionary, and image URL string. It's a neat, effective alternative to the if statements we had there previously. Now, back up here, let's put back in the check to see if error equals nil, this time using a guard statement. Now you'll notice with all of these, the guard statement keeps the conditions and associated errors to display in one place, which ends up making our code a lot cleaner. Lastly, let's just add in a few more error checks. Did we get a successful HTTP response? This statement checks to make sure our status code is in the 200s range, or the success range. Now let's check down here, after we've used NSJSON serialization, to see what we're saving in parse result is actually okay and usable. Great! We're responsibly checking for errors. Note that we can actually combine many of these guard statements together, but we've separated each into its own statement to make it more clear what their purposes are. If you feel comfortable with what each of these statements does, you can feel free to combine them yourself.